now tuned in to a podcast we now call Podikins Presents.
I am a banana.
He's actually eating a banana.
Banana.
Turn it up.
Hear ye, hear ye. One and all.
Turn it up.
You're now tuned in to a channel we call...
Turn it up.
Podikins Presents. This week, Podikins presents an interview with the gravy boat captain.
Welcome everyone to Podikins Presents. I'm your host, Andrew. And if things sound a little crazy this week, it's because we're currently experiencing a bit of a flood here in Podikins Studio.
Check, check.
That sound you hear in the background, that's my trusty producer, James, setting up all our recording equipment.
Andrew, could I get a couple checks into your microphone?
Oh, sure.
Check, check, check. Sound good?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay. And why are we setting up recording equipment in the middle of a flood, you might be asking? That's a good question. But it's because we had a very special visitor today who popped in out of the blue, completely unexpected, while we were trying to clean up this flood, and he agreed to sit down with us and answer all of your questions.
Potty, could I get some checks into your mic?
Oh, right. This again. Fine. I'm back. Check, 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 check. 1, 2, 1, 2, check, okay, 1, 2, check, 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 check. Let's get to it. Where are these questions, huh? You said there would be questions, huh? From listeners or something.
Before we play the rest of this interview, the interview we cobbled together while our studio was flooding, I guess I need to explain a couple of things.
Please listen carefully.
If you didn't recognize that voice,
check. Check. Check.
Then you should head on back to episode 4 and listen to the story of how we first met Potty. And if you did recognize this voice,
1, 2, 1, 2, check, check.
Then you were probably wondering when he'd be back. As you'll recall, we first met Potty, a strange little creature, when he popped out from under the footstool.
Whoa!
And we asked him a couple questions before he took off.
How old are you?
How old am I? I don't know. We don't worry about that.
Who's we?
But he agreed he'd come back.
Sure. Why not?
And we asked if you had any questions.
So what should we ask Potty when he comes back? Do you have any questions for him?
And we got some great questions from you. But, just like the first time we met Potty, this time, he also made quite an entrance.
Whoa!
So settle in. Because after the break, we have the story, Potty's Return. Our story begins last week. There was a big rainstorm, which was pretty surprising, because it's usually snowing here in Canada at this time of year. But, in the middle of the night, during that big rainstorm, I was suddenly woken up.
Ah! What?
By a frantic phone call from James.
Andrew! 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 The studio is flooding! The studio is flooding! The studio is flooding! Who is this?
As far as I could tell, from the tone of James's voice, it was as if the studio was flooding.
Yes, the studio is flooding! Get over here!
So I hopped in the car and drove over to Podikins headquarters.
Ooh, girl, baby, please don't go.
When I got there, it was confirmed. The studio was indeed flooding.
Hey, James.
Whoa, it seems like the studio is flooding.
Yes, obviously. I told you that on the phone.
Okay. Deep breaths. Have you figured out where it's coming from?
No, there's too much water. I can't tell where anything's coming from. All I can see is water.
James. Hold on a second. Well, I think what we need to do is figure out where it's coming from.
I told you, I can't figure out where it's coming from.
Well, I think we need to find the source. Where do you think?
All I can see is water.
Could it be from over there?
I don't know.
Could it be from over here?
It could be anywhere.
We need to find the source, James.
I don't know.
While James and I were bickering,
I really think we should find the source of the leak.
Out of the corner of my eye, I spotted the strangest thing.
James, look at that!
What? What is that?
Is that a...
a gravy boat?
It was, in fact, a gravy boat. And it was floating down the stream that had formed in Podikins Studio. And perched on top of it, paddling with a wooden spoon, was... Potty.
Potty?
Ahoy there, fellas. Looks like the studio has sprung a leak. Or rather, sprung a river.
We knew he wouldn't stick around for long, so we immediately stopped mopping up the water and started setting up our gear.
Let's get to it. Where are these questions, huh? You said there would be questions, huh? From listeners or something.
Okay, James, cue up the questions.
All right, the questions are cued.
Took you long enough. Let's hear them. No time to waste, even in haste.
All right. Our first questions are about your birthday.
What year was he born in?
What day is his birthday?
Whoa! That's a lot of questions. But since it's coming from the listeners, and not you two nobodies, I reckon I'll give you a proper answer. Like I told you last time, we don't worry about ages. We got no time for it. But, of course, I do know me birthday. Who doesn't? I was born in the third phase of Snaggy Bloomin', on the 75th day of Grennis Blobble.
Sounds a little odd.
Odd to you, maybe, but not to me, you see?
Okay, well, I guess you guys must just have a different calendar or something.
Enough of that talk. Calendars and such. I'll hear none of it. Next question.
Okay. We've got another one coming. And it has to do with where you're from.
Is there a lot... Oh, wait, no. Where do you live?
Where do I live? I can let you know that I live down by the river. Down by two rivers, in fact. And in fact, that's where all the Podikins live. Wherever and whenever you see two rivers, creeks, brooks, lakes, oceans, or any two bodies of water coming together, you better believe that there's Podikins around. And we play. And sometimes, we do, in fact, work. But not too much of that, you know?
What kind of work?
Oh, are you asking the questions now?
Sorry, no. I was just curious, and I think our listeners might be as well. What kind of work?
Well, if it's for the listeners, then fine, I'll answer it. Well, you know wildflowers? And other vegetation you see growing in the woods? Well... any of that stuff you see growing down by streams or rivers or ponds and the like, well, that's us Podikins doing. We tend to them and we take care of them. We plant them, we trim them, we water them, and all that. And have you ever walked along a path in the woods near water?
Yes, I have.
How do you think that path got there? Magic? No, sir. It's all us Podikins. We walk up and down and up and down and... all of us together, well, we make a nice path for all of you. Anyways, what were the other questions?
Okay, well, we've got another one queued up.
Do you have a house?
Well, for a house, us Podikins live in the trees. The trees down by the water. Sometimes, there's up to 100 of us. Piled in that one tree. Next question.
You got it. James?
Potty, what's your favorite thing to do? Are you friends with any fairies or gnomes?
Ah, you sound like a nice lass. So I'll answer it for you. My favorite thing to do? Well, that's easy. It's nothing. Nothing, 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 nothing. But I don't do nothing like you do nothing, not doing anything at all. When we Podikins do nothing, it really is something. You've got to see it, one and all. And yes, I am friends with some fairies, to answer your second question. I'm really good friends with some flower fairies, actually. My best flower fairy friend is named Rose. And she's sweet as can be. Can you guess what kind of flower fairy she is?
I'm gonna guess she's a rose fairy?
You're a swift one, ain't ya? Swifter than most of the gnomes I've come across. But that's not saying much. You see, we Podikins, we don't get along too kindly with the gnomes. No, 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 gnomes. Not since the first phase of Bloomus Blingus. Because back then, well, I don't want to get into it, but let's just say there was an incident. And since then, yeah, I've met some gnomes that weren't half bad, but most of them were all bad. Next question.
Okay. Our next one's a little personal, but some of our listeners were wondering about your family.
Does he have a sister that likes to play with him?
Do you have any parents?
Of course I have parents. I wouldn't be here if I didn't, silly. Me Ma and me Pa are quite near and dear to me, in fact. Me Pa was the first person to teach me how to play Rippity Dippins. And me Ma taught me how to bake the best crunchkin cake you've ever tasted, and you would never want to not taste it again. You hear me? And yes, I've got sisters, 28 of them to be exact, and 35 brothers. 17 of me sisters are older than me, but I'm the youngest of the fellas in my family for now, don't you see? Which reminds me, I gotta get going.
Now hold on a second, Potty. We just have a few more questions.
Fine. I'll do it for the listeners.
Is Potty an animal, a person, or a different species?
Oh, that's an easy one. All of the above.
What? All of the above? That doesn't make any sense. You're going to have to explain that to me.
Nope. Next question.
Well, a lot of our listeners were really curious about your hat.
Me hat. Is it a new hat?
Where did he get it?
Is it a sun hat?
Is it a Christmas hat?
Is it a summer hat?
How do they know what my hat looks like? Have you been taking pictures?
Actually, a listener asked a question about that, too.
Potty, why didn't you want to have any pictures taken?
Wait, Potty, where are you going? Potty!
And before that question even finished playing, Potty was gone. All we saw was the wake his gravy boat left behind. We tried to yell out to him that we didn't take
Potty,
a picture.
Potty!
It was just
Potty,
a drawing.
It was just a drawing.
Just art. Liz made it.
Come back.
But there was no response.
Potty!
I think he's gone, Andrew.
Well, what do we do?
I think we made him really angry when we talked about his hat.
Wonder why that is. I mean, they took off.
Hey, Andrew. Is it just me, or does it seem like the water's slowing down?
It's almost stopped.
Look at it, it's drying up.
How did it do that?
Do you think?
No, there's no way.
Could it have been?
You don't think.
Potty? Potty?
Podikins is created by James Nicholson and Andrew Whitfield.
This week's music comes from Patrick Lee, Tritakian, and Jazzer.
Artwork by Liz Whitehead.
Matt Schichter is Golden Tone.
And a special thanks to all of you who sent in questions! That's right, I'm talking about you, Charlie, Lucy, Lila, Colin, Katie, Ryan, Linda J, and Linda N!
One more thing. For those of you who are curious about Potty's hat, well, you're in luck. As Potty was rushing out of the studio, he dropped a piece of paper that had instructions for how to make a hat just like his. There's a link to the instructions right in the show notes, or you can check them out on our website, podikins.fm. Thanks for listening, and be sure to subscribe and leave a rating and review on iTunes. And if you have any more questions for Potty, send them in to share@podikins.fm or post them on our Facebook page. We'll talk to you again in 2 weeks.
What's the pot again?